kaysa nung mga nakalipas at kung sapat na raw ba yung prosecution kay GMA para masabing tagumpay ang pakikibaka sa korupsyon ng pamahalaan.
Hindi pa nakikita talaga ang political will na kalabanin ang korupsyon kasi parang discriminate. No, hindi lahat, marami rin tayong balitang korupsyon sa present administration at wala namang napananagot pa. No, kaya sana maging seryoso tayo kung talagang korupsyon, no, walang kaibigan, walang kasama, no, walang kapartido. Ngunit kung sino nagkakamali, dapat i-prosecute.
Towards the end of your statement, you said you commend and support lay initiatives to form circles of discernment to choose worthy candidates. Is this a roundabout way of the church telling its flock to vote for, to not vote against people who passed the RH law?
Well, I think that also refers to what the so-called Catholic vote, no? So, first of all, we do not want to use the phrase Catholic vote because it can easily be misinterpreted because it has so many meanings. No? But as a CBCP, we commend and appreciate the lay groups who are working for the election of candidates who are upright and competent and who are guided by the moral teachings of the church.
Do you think those who pass for the RH law are unworthy candidates?
Well, it's up to the voter to decide on that after knowing the moral teachings of the church. Because in the elections, in trying to choose the candidate, there are so many issues involved. No? As we always say, no, kahit naman siya, he voted, let's say, no to the arrest bill, but if he's corrupted, he's not competent. So we have to weigh all these issues, and we have to weigh whether the good qualities are more weighty than the bad qualities in a candidate. So we leave it to the voter to decide.
I noticed in your statement that you seem to be at loggerheads with the government at the moment, precisely with a lot of issues. Is the church, in your opinion, losing its steam at the moment, considering that you fought hard for the RH law, but then it still passed?
I would like you to know that what we wrote is not retaliation against anybody for what happened to RH bill. It is a product of discernment and prayer and inspired by the love of the country, by the love of people and what we think is good. That's one. Second, we do not want to appear, you know, self-righteous, you know, that we have no shortcomings and failures. Yet we feel that as shepherds, it is also part of our duty to voice out, you know, the sentiments of the people. And if we do this, it is not because we want to condemn, but it is because we want that all of us, you know, will try to take a hard look over these realities and hopefully, prayerfully, be able to come out with solutions. So we don't want to appear like, you know, fighting anybody. As I mentioned at the start, our main intention is really the good of the people. And even in my message to the bishop, the language, our language, even if may appear like, you know, hard, but our language is not a language of retaliation, never a language of hatred, but it is a language of love.
I would like to point out the last paragraph of our statement. It was not read, but it's very important. Now, I'll read. Our pastoral statement addresses the political and social issues that bring them deeper into helplessness and hopelessness, that is, the poor. We must voice out the concerns of the poor for their moral guide, to be their moral guide, be with them, the unborn and the little ones, the young, the women, the farmers, the indigenous peoples, the slum dwellers, the workers, the fisher folks, the migrants. Our love has to bring them the good news, the gospel, with all its social, political, and ethical implications. So that's important. This is the reason why we bring this out, no, to help the poor.
I will just add to what Mr. Broderick said. You know, the bishops, I think we have the right to claim that we are also citizens of the country, and we can also say that we are doing our best to love the country. And so with regards to the government, we can say that our attitude is what we usually call critical collaboration. If the government is doing something good for the country, we will always help, collaborate. But if it's doing something evil for the country, we will not, we will criticize and we will oppose.
Especially po sa senatorian, eh kung hindi anak, kapatid, pamangkin, so it's really magkakamag-anak. So sa ganito po ba, sinasabi rin po ba natin sa ating mga botante na dahil sa ganitong kalagayan po nila, eh huwag nating iboto yung mga political dynasties. In clear terms, hindi po yung ambivalent.
Kung babasahin itong pastoral statement, maliwanag na sinasabi rito na hindi tama itong political dynasties, na wala tayong batas dyan. Ngayon, ang mga hindi namin sinasabi sa mga botante, sinong bobotohin? No, ginagalang namin ang kanilang konsyensya, we give them the guidance, no, kaya sila ang pipili. Pero sinasabi dito, hindi tama na ang sistema ngayon ay nandyan at hindi makakatulong sa ating bansa.
Basihan natin ang konstitusyon. It's in the constitution that there should be no political dynasties. Kaya pinapaulap lang namin something that is written in our constitution na I guess na what the constitution is the let's say principles, pero kailangan natin magkaroon ng batas. Kaya yun ang ito yung anti-dynasty law ko sakali. Kung talagang iinak ng Congress.
May panawagan din po ba tayo dun sa mga politiko po ba na alam naman nila na yung tsuhi nila o yung tatay nila eh kumakandidato pero kumakandidato pa rin sila? Meron po ba kayong panawagan para sa kanila?
Sa aming mga reflections, homilies, ay ginawa ng Diyos ang mundo, pinagkalooban tayo ng talino. Ito'y para sa lahat at hindi lang para sa iilan. Naniniwala naman tayo lahat dito, we have all the talents, ano? Kaya na nga, ay wala silang opportunities, wala silang pera, wala silang structure. Eh kung hindi tutulungan ng ating gobyerno na maalis itong unbalance nito, may structure sila, may pera sila, may power sila, eh paano yung mga talented na wala nito? Kaya napakahirap. Tulungan natin. Diyan kailangan natin ng mga laws that will strengthen this article of our constitution.
As a citizen, kagaya po na nabanggit ninyo, at kayo boboto, is being a member of political dynasty a disqualification on your vote?
Kung boboto tayo, dapat may mga negative, positive points at i-weigh up natin kung tama o hindi. Na surely, kapag nasa political dynasty, isang negative point na yan. No, may mga i-balance natin. No, this will not help sa right justice ng pagboboto.
How about po yung RH supporters? Yun po ba'y isang sapat na para maging diskwalifikasyon sa pagpili ng mga botante kung sino boboto?
Kanina nga, as the chairman's what Bishop Roderick Pavillo said, in for the voter to decide, he should list all the good qualities and bad qualities of a candidate, no? If he has more weighty good qualities, then vote for him. If it has more weighty bad qualities, then do not vote for him. But to me, support for their RH is one of the negative qualities.
So, isa lang sa mga?
Sa mga many other qualities, no?
Apo, so,
like for example, he is corrupt, and that's a bad quality yan. He's incompetent, no? He is, he deceives people. And one thing, another one is that he voted for the RH bill. Yes, no? Yeah.
So yung boto po ng mambabata sa RH bill is not end all be all kung iboboto o hindi na kandidato?
Yeah, as far as I can interpret, it's not the only criterion. No? There are many other criterions. No?
Okay.
Kasi kung yung kalaban niya, sabi ko nga, no nga to RH, pero loko-loko naman, corrupted and everything. Why should I also just vote for that one? That's why to weigh the, as Broderick said, good qualities and bad qualities, and which is weightier.
Kay Bishop Gabby, sir, sabi nyo kanina kapag ka yung government ay good, tapos evil, parang susuportahan kapag ka good, kapag evil, babati ko si parang ganon. So, ano po bang ginagawa? Ang gobyerno po ba natin, good or evil?
Or it's not black and white, di ba? May good naman, may evil din. Life is not just black and white.
How far are you willing to collaborate with the government considering the goodwill, quote-unquote, that transpired since June 30 of 2010? So how long will you collaborate with this government?
Ang collaboration sa gobyerno, hindi yan yes or no. Depende sa program. Sa program na maganda, sama tayo dyan. Sa program na hindi maganda, patikusin natin yan. No? So hindi yan na in toto. No, sa mga programa nila, kung saan tulad na ngayon, ang peace process sa Mindanao, no, umuunsad siya, gumaganda. Sino suportahan yan, ang peace process na yan? No, in that sense. No, kaya hindi yan na either or.
Be specific tayo sa mga bagyo, sa mga ganyan. Ang tulong ay sa amin. At ang mga tao ay mas gusto magbigay sa amin kasi sa gobyerno. Basically, kami mga pare, pumupunta sa mga barangay, yung mga pare namin, alam namin kung sino talaga yun ang salanta. Pag pinadaan mo sa gobyerno, paradaan nila sa kanilang structures na mayroong barangay captain, eh, hindi naman alam yung talaga ng salanta, eh hindi. Kaya sa ganitong, as much as possible, sa ganitong rehabilitation, pagtulong sa mga mahihirap, eh napakahirap makipag-coordinate. Kasi hindi naman nagdi-deliver. Kaya kami, walang ingay, walang media, ang dami namin nagagawa. At sa amin ang tiwala at tulong ng tao.
Gusto ko nga lang ibalik yung principle na sinasabi ni Bishop Broderick na yung critical collaboration, yung pagtingin sa programa, at of course, no, we assess the program, and if in our assessment maganda, at marami namang maganda, no, all out support tayo, no? Pero kaya nang sinabi niya, kung palagay nga namin hindi, then of course we say we are against it or we do not support it because it is contrary to our conviction of what's good.
Yeah, are you optimistic, bishops, that the coming elections will be fair, honest, and credible?
We can only hope and pray, no? And optimism is part of the Christian virtue, no? Kaya lang gusto natin makita na as early as this time, yung mga fears natin, may mga kasagutan na rin na makikita, no? Kasi it's not only we, no? Or it's not so much we, no? Maraming na rin grupo, both individuals and institutions, na maraming pangamba, no, sa forthcoming elections. Kaya nga, I repeat, no, we are not saying no, we're holier than others, pero we voice out the concern of many because we would wish and we want that election as a process would truly be credible. Kaya lang, until and unless these guarantees are being in place, patuloy tayong nangangamba. No, pero, I repeat, no, we are hopeful, prayerful, and we do what we can to make this election truly reflect the will of the people.
This is why we are addressing this automated election. Kasi maraming mga questions dito. Kaya hinihingi namin sa COMELEC na sana sagutin ang mga questions na ito, no, para magkaroon talaga ng trust ang mga tao sa sistemang ginagamit.
And the church is not only hoping for a fair, honest election, but it's doing something to have a fair and honest election through the Parish Council PCRB, Pastoral Council for Responsible Voting, and so NAMFRER and things sample in Cebu. Yeah, they it's long, many years already, many elections. We are doing our best to have honest and free elections.
Ika nga ng headline po sa dyaryo, nakalagay doon na pagkatapos ng RH law, divorce naman po ang sunod na target nila. Ano po ba ang target? Ano nung pong gagawin ninyo? Gagawa po ba kayo ng survey ulit? Or ano pong magandang move po para ma, ano po ang mga tao?
Well, as was said here, we are doing our best to intensify our catechesis or conscientization of our people regarding the Christian values of marriage. What is really marriage? So that then, in the Christian marriage concept, divorce is wrong. So if people know that it's wrong, well, they will lobby with their congressmen that they should not vote for this. And also our congressmen, our Catholic congressmen, also that they will realize that divorce is wrong. No? To me, a Catholic, if he's a Catholic, he should act in accordance with his conscience. And he should do his best to have a correct conscience. And for a Catholic, a correct conscience is a conscience that is in accord with the moral teachings of the Church. So that's why we also commend those lay groups who are trying their best to work for the election of candidates who are upright and competent and are guided by the moral teachings of the Church. So that this coming bills of divorce, I hope not later on, this same-sex marriage, then maybe this, I hope it will not come, abortion, because in other countries, first it is contraception, and then abortion comes, and then euthanasia comes, and all this. That's why we are really concerned with the passing of the marriage bill, because in other countries, that was the experience. Contraception, and then wherever contraception is dominant, the what they call abortion culture is also dominant. So then they will pass the abortion bills. Like in the U.S., no? Then they have this euthanasia, and same-sex marriage, I'm repeating myself.
Yun nga po, katulad sinasabi na divorce po, tayo na lang bansang walang ganon, kinaklarify nila. Meron po bang particular step na talagang makaka-impluensya dito sa mga politiko na to? Pagdating sa ganyan.
Meron po bang atakeng gagawin ang simbahan?
Sa ngayon, yung pagtingin namin, hindi na lang basta inaatake yung negative. No? Pakita namin, kung pagkukulan natin ng pansin at pag-aaral, yung positive sa buhay natin, yun yung isang magandang turo against siguro sa what we fear. No? Alimbawa lang, yung mga dalaga dito, no? Hindi pa nga nakasal, alam mo na anytime iwanan ka na lang, no, kasi mag-divorce, no, kasi madali mag-divorce. I think deep in the human heart is also the desire for a love, no, that transcends kahit ordinary suffering, no. Yung point ko is deep in the human heart is the desire to respect the person, no. Deep in the human heart is a desire to live a life na that would perpetuate itself, no, in the children. So, itong mga positive na mga values, palagay nga namin, Christian nga, pero they are very human, no? At maraming cultures na maganda tingnan na they recognize the values. Yung pagtingin namin, hindi na lang basta ginawa sa ibang lugar gawin natin, no? Kasi para sa akin, pag-aralan din natin yung talagang maganda, yung talagang mga values natin na you know, longings of the human heart. Ika nga, there are thirsts and hungers in the human heart. And I believe much of this revolve around the beauty of love, the beauty of a lasting relationship, the gift of children, you know, the family that extends for, you know, another generation. Hindi na matapos dahil ayaw magkaanak. And all of these things. So, siguro, what I am driving at is part of the Church evangelization program is to ask ano ba yung magaganda na dapat i-focus, no? And related or to the issue of divorce, yung we're happy with people na mag-celebrate ng Silver Jubilee, Golden Jubilee, you know. We're happy with people na, you know, despite difficulties, no, they strive, no, to love each other. We're happy with children, with parents who love with their children. We're happy with people who, you know, who can claim to the world that, you know, they're they're blessed, you know, with a good and lasting family life. No, so all of these are part of the catechesis that we would like to impart to people to show that the fears we have against the death bells are valid, not only from the Christian point of view, but even from human point of view.
Para sa akin, eh, pakikita ko yung negative fruit ng divorce. Ito po'y alam namin sapagkat kami nagbibigay ng recollection sa mga bata. Napakahirap kapag hiwalay ang magulang at ano. Kitang-kita niyo yung struggle ng bata. Lalo tuturuan namin sila ng gratitude. Pagdating na ng gratitude, hirap na hirap ang mga anak ng hiwalay. Paano ko pasasalamatan ang aking magulang? Yan. Part niya ng education eh. Itong ating death of gratitude, utang na loob. Kaya yung negative dimension ng divorce ang pakikita namin.
You mentioned daw po in your statement that you will help the people know the candidate's stance on issues. How do you intend to do this?
Actually, marami nang ginagawa. Hindi lang masyado napapublicize. Pero itong gagawin ng Catholic Media Network, ang Catholic Media Network deals more dun sa communities kasi yun ang simbahan, yung mga komunidad. So, we are organizing that for the coming 2 months. Yung sa lahat ng networks namin, pipiliting lumabas ang kung tawagin nating walk the talk and talk the walk. Kasi pag ano, pag salita lang, ang dami. Every year na lang, sawan-sawa tayo. Pero we'll try to do it in such a way na lumalabas yung mga ebidensya sa pagkilala sa mga kandidato. Tsaka focusing on the moral stance of the church and their conviction on their person and the way they will run the country as their ultimate purpose in governance.
For the past, sinasabi namin sa mga tao yung mga criteria, pro-God, pro-poor, pro-environment. Pero yung mga tao nahihirapan magkuhan sa isang taong ito, pro-God ba siya o ano? No, kaya we move a little another step further. We will identify issues that are important for the nation or sa mga province, for the province. Kunyari, issue ng mining, issue ng divorce, issue ng agrarian reform o ano pa ng religious people, basta anong mga important issues. And then, we will ask, this is a service that we can do, we will ask the candidates, ano ang stand mo dyan sa isyong yan? No? And then, afterwards, we'll bring it out to the people. Ito yung issues, ito yung stand ng mga candidates. Bumoto kayo, depende, pipili kayo. So, matutulungan namin silang pumili. Ngayon sakali ang mga candidates ayaw magbigay ng stand, it's very negative. Tatakbo ka, wala kang stand sa issue na ito. No, napakahalaga. No, ibig sabihin na ayaw mo manindigan. No, and that's a very negative thing. No, kaya iyan ang hihingi namin. So we will identify important issues and ask the candidates what are your stand here and bring it out to the public. No? Ah? Kaya nga, ito niya, si Pinoy, FOI, pinanindigan niya yan, hindi niya pinindigan ngayon, pwedeng ilabas yan, no?
Kay Archbishop Palma po, you mentioned po yung sa COMELEC, they have to adequately address and respond to the questions. Does that mean po na when they presented to you kahapon, hindi po kayo nasatisfied dun sa, ano po nila, sa presentation po nila?
Yung nangyari kasi dahil sa kakulang ng oras, no? How we wish that we have a longer time. Kaya lang, no, I was even joking yung mga congressmen, kayo, you come to Manila and you meet 120 days in a year. Kami na mga bispo, twice lang kami pupunta. Every time you gather, 2 days lang, no, 2 days and a half, no. Kaya ang daming issue, halos limited yung time, kaya hindi matutukan. Now to answer your question, walang oportunidad nga na ma-clarify yung maraming issues. Si Bishop Broderick brought up a lot more issues, pero wala ngang panahon. So in that sense, kulang, no? Kulang. Hindi kontento dahil sinagot na hindi kontento, pero wala ngang chance magsagot, wala ngang chance magpaliwanag. And this is what we mean. Kaya nga, the many fears that we expose, no, or we surface para sa atin, malaking matutulong kung in the course of time, no, lalo na part of the trust that we hope will happen would be when COMELEC would come out and say, this has been brought out, sabi nga nila, ganito, ganito, no? And this is how we respond. It's siyempre yung mga tao, pag para sa kanila nakakontento, then they will say, yun na pala, may response naman. But we have to see the response, and it has to really be you know, like, a clear, lalo na sa mga bumoboto at kandidato. Kasi sa amin, why would we bring this out? No, hindi naman kami kandidato, no? But because we care for the people, we care for the process, we care for our country. At para sa atin, napakahalaga na yung election exercise would truly be clean, honest, and peaceful.
In fairness naman to the COMELEC, one of the things which was asked, which I asked, was because one politician told me, when you meet the COMELEC, you ask this question. He said in the last election, there was no manual random audit that very night, and it should be done that very night. In many places, it was 1 week after or 1 month after. Now, the manual random audit is done, and they only choose precincts to know whether what the pickers reported is the same as the ballots that were there, which was counted manually. And they said they will do their best. Now, that very night of the election, there will be already a manual random audit. So, ano naman sila? May goodwill din naman.
I'm interested in the how. So, we have the content of what you want to say. Then you said that we will assess the different issues per locality. How are you going to do it? Are you going to do it by BEC, by parish, something like that? Yeah. So, I'm asking about the action. What action?
First, in the national level, so we will try to meet with some groups and identify issues that are important. No? And then we can go to the candidates, write them letters, no, interview them, no, in order to see their stance on this. Now, in the province, our social action centers can do the same process. Identify the issues that are important for the province, and then ask those who are running for provincial seats, what are the stance on this? And that can also be done in the cities. No, so this is still, we are beginning to do this, so I don't know how far we will succeed, but at least we're going along that way to help our people discern and know better the candidates and to make the candidates stand on issues and not just on names or personalities.
Ano raw po ba kung may reaction kayo as an individual bishops doon sa awayan sa Senado?
As Cardinal Chito said, that lunch is supposed to be a respite, no? Like a parang rest, no? From you know, our many concerns. So, and supposed to be, no, while sharing at meal, no? Walang away, no? Wala doon kahapon, no? And sana permin na lang may meal, no? Para wala nang away, no? But anyway, our prayer is whatever, you know, whatever, ano ba yung tawag niyo sa Tagalog, no? Bangayan, no? Bangayan, no? Could be thrashed out, and we are a people who love peace, you know, and understanding, and whatever personal issues sana, no, should give way to the good of the country, the good of the people.
Yung sa issue po ni Carlos Seldran, yung Damaso issue.
Yung nakita ko kahapon sa news, no, para sa akin, the court has spoken and we respect the court, no, and our part, even long before, no, we have forgiven him. So whatever the court decides, we respect. No, we are a people who respect the processes of the court, and more than anything else, no, siguro love should reign, and we have learned our lesson in the process, no. I mean, everybody understands nga, respect should be given, no, to every religion. We respect the place, no, and above all, love should reign. No? So the court has spoken para sa amin. We just say amen to the court's decision.